Guys, it's Megan Rose from the Philippines. Welcome to my channel. It's called Gantsilyera, a show and tell of crochet and craft related items. So today is November 4, 2019, a Monday, and the kids are back to school. And sorry if my voice is raspy, I have some cold and cough. So I wasn't able to make a video yesterday because I woke up pretty late and I needed to prepare for church. So today, welcome to my new and old subscribers. Thank you for taking the time out of your day to visit with me. So I just want to show you the projects that I have been making this past week, and afterwards discuss some life stuff or some happenings. So first off, I want to show you the headbands. So I was able to sew in the ends for these knitted headbands that I have been making in the past. And these past days, I was working on some detachable flowers. So what it is I have put some buttons directly to the headbands. And I have made some flowers with big holes in the middle part so as to detach and attach it to the buttons. So I have made the 9 flowers for the 9 headbands. So this is how it turned out. And what I'm thinking about this is I'm gonna make another design for the flowers with the big hole in the middle as some type of alternate for these ones, so that I can put them on my shop with an added feature to it. So these are the headbands I've been working on. I was able to make the flowers, and they are in different colors and different middle parts with and an assortment of buttons also. So this is the last one. So what I'm thinking is I have rummaged some of the flowers that I have made from before, and I'm gonna try to make them in this design and just put a bigger hole in the middle. I also have the option of this. So I have these other options for flowers. Some type of alternative for the ones that I have made for the headband. So I have this one which is using some popcorn stitches. So I just needed to make the middle hole a little bit wider so as to attach the buttons. I have this one, and I have this other one here that I think I have shown you. I have this other option. And I think for this one, I needed to make it a little bit bigger, or maybe put 3 to 4 layers to it. And then I have this other one that is formed in a spiral. So this is worked in some type of crochet piece that is rectangular. And then they are sewn together in a spiral way to turn into this type of flower. So the only issue here is that it doesn't have a hole in the middle to insert the buttons to, but I will try to fiddle with it and maybe find out something just to put the hole in the middle for it. So those are the first projects I want to show you guys, and I also want to show you my finished item, which is the toothless amigurumi. The last time I have shown it to you was I have formed the body with the head, and also the front and back legs, and also the ears and the bumps. So this past week I was able to form the wing part for it. So this is how it looks like. So I have made 2 pieces of this, actually 4, because I sewn together 2 flaps so that it will be much more sturdier. So because just one flap is a bit flimsy, So I sewn together two flaps for this, and it turned out this way. And also, I was also able to put the toe parts for the toothless or the nail parts, just using some bubble stitches. And I was also able to attach the tail along with some more bumps. And for the eyes, I didn't use the crochet piece because I don't think the eyes pops out. So what I did is I bought some felt cloth. I bought some felt cloth in green just for Toothless's eyes. And from the picture, I was able to trace the shape of it. And the other day, I used my glue gun to attach it, but it short-circuited, so I wasn't able to use it. So I borrowed my sister's glue gun just to finish this, because I was in a finishing mode this past week, and I really want to finish Toothless. I was able to take some pictures of it, and I'm going to put that on my shop so that people will buy it from me if they are interested. And if you are interested in purchasing Toothless, I'm going to put him on my shop, and I will put the link on the description box below. So the other finished item that I have made this past week is Stuart. And this is, I think, the fifth or the sixth Stuart that I have made so far. This past week, I was able to attach the jumper, the boots along with the legs, the gloves with the hands. I was able to attach the pocket and the buttons along with the jumper strap, and also this back part here. I was able to attach the eyes and put a smile on him, and also the strap for the goggles. He also has this hair here that I embroidered at the top of his head, and I'm really happy it turned out quite cute. And I'm going to put this on my shop also so that people get caught. I hope that buyers, I will catch the eye of the buyers for this one. So this is how it turned out. I'm gonna finish the hippo next. So I have also been working on that, and I have made both arms for him, for the hippo. This is how I got so far with the arms. And I'm going to work on the legs next, and I'm thinking about making it just like Doopies, wherein you have this feet part here and the leg part is just a very long cylindrical piece. So that's what I'm gonna be working on next. And then I'm gonna show you some yarn purchases that I had this past week. I was able to go to Tabora last Wednesday and purchase some felt cloth for Toothless. So I was able to buy some variegated yarn from my suki, which is in Tabora, Divisoria. If you want to go there, the store is called GST Supply. Beside it is another store that I always went to or goes to, which is called Everson. If you want to go there, those are the places that I purchase my yarn from. So from GST, I was able to buy some Loveknots yarn that are in variegated colors, and they are 35 meters long. So I purchased these colors here, these two ones. And what I'm gonna make out of this are the granny squares, so that I can add up to the ones that I already have. We have the shades here, also those ones. And I bought a whole pack of this, which is 10 pieces per pack. And I think they have a lesser amount when you buy it in bulk. And also, I have this one. And since I wanted to buy more colors of yarn for the flowers for the headbands, I also bought some from Everson, which are this. This one is called Familia Premium Yarn, and they are 18 grams. So I purchased one in pink, fuchsia pink, light blue, and this other shade of blue here. We had a busy week, and I have listed here where we went. But last Sunday, I was able to put up the bead starter kit. Monday, I was able to make the tutorial for the last letter of the beaded tutorial series, which is the letter Z. I also had an order then, a second order from my shop. But the consignee wasn't able to receive it for the two times that they tried to deliver it. So maybe it's because of the her schedule. Last Tuesday, we went to Trinoma and SM North to have one of the cell phones checked. It was the one that Marius has been using for some time, but the LCD is cracked and the power button is not working. So we were able to take it there, but we haven't got it fixed because it is a little bit pricey. Last Wednesday, I was able to go to the Visoria to purchase the materials I needed to finish Toothless, and also I have purchased the yarns. Thursday, we had the rest, but my aunt invited us last Thursday to watch Itbulaga, but we weren't able to come because Friday, we went to Manila Memorial and we meet our aunt there, or my aunt there, to visit some dead relatives. And last Saturday, we went to another cemetery where my other aunt was buried. So those are the stuff that happened these past days. And as you can see, I have put up some new background, which are some butterflies, and I really love how it is. I wasn't able to show you because I was here, so I decided to go in this position just to show you guys. So I think those are most of it. I have shown you most of my projects, and I'm happy to catch up with you. So I hope you have a fine day today, crafting, and some relaxing time after a day's work, and also, as I always say, some family bonding time. That's it from me. Bye for now.